Well, thank God. Thank God I'm in my living room. I need to get to a computer. I need to find out the truth. I need to find out who killed Jack Phillips. Where is that computer? Bingo.
Hi, I'm Sean Bradley, the writer, director, co-producer, and star of Scoptophobia. Scoptophobia is the story of Vincent, played by me, a bored and egocentric office worker. He's got a cushy job. A lovely fiancée named Sylvia, despite the fact that he has a bit of a crush on her best friend Cordelia. In a moment of weakness, temptation takes hold. One thing leads to another, and Vincent ends up making a life-altering mistake. So, after a night of passionate lovemaking, he leaves the apartment to witness a murder. And the wrong man gets charged for it. And to make things worse, guess who's representing him?
Gee, is it Sylvia?
How do you exonerate a man when you're the only person who knows he's innocent? Do you tell his lawyer everything you know, knowing that it would be the end of your relationship? And how do you help your fiancé solve this case without it in any way linking back to you?
So many questions.
Scoptophobia, or scopophobia, is the fear of being looked at, seen, or stared at. As with most phobias, scopophobia generally arises from a traumatic event in the person's life.
Scopophobia is another definition? Why didn't he just call it that instead? 'Cause damn it, scoptophobia sounds better.
While there are traces of this phobia in Vincent, the title is a metaphor for Vincent's plight. He is afraid of being seen for a cheater and a liar. He is afraid of taking responsibility for his one-night stand and telling Sylvia the truth. And that fear will be triggered by the murder of Jack Phillips, an event that will dominate the entire narrative of the film.
Lady in the Lake from 1947.
Scoptophobia, just like Lady in the Lake, will be shot
entirely in first person from Vincent's perspective. Characters will be interacting with Vincent while I'm wearing a GoPro or some spyglasses, as if everything is normal. While it is shot in first person, Vincent narrates the film through his thoughts.
Like the protagonist in a film noir, see?
Stanley Kubrick.
Kubrick is a revolutionary filmmaker, and he is one of my favourite directors, and this film has a few Kubrickian touches to it, including a few musical nods to Eyes Wide Shut and A Clockwork Orange. He has been an inspiration to so many filmmakers, including me, and I just feel so inspired by his work. And some of that stuff I do want to actually emulate in Scoptophobia. I have always been interested in films since an early stage in my life. I would put on videos and just re-watch them over and over again. Over the years, I have developed this strong sense of imagination and a hunger for adventure. And I thought that it would be so exciting to be in these adventurous situations. Growing up on films and television has helped me to understand the world in which I live in. Filmmaking and performing is very interesting and is a passion to me because it is so much fun to create things.
I have previously studied a further education course in creative media, thus giving me the experience and confidence to tackle a project such as this.
Scoptophobia will be my first feature film as a director, which is what I envision myself doing in the future. And it will also be the first feature film to be produced by my production company, Elements S Films.
I intend to start filming at around either late August or early September, so that I can finish filming and editing by the end of the year. My goal is to get the film to be distributed by a studio, as well as to get the film in cinemas.
And here is where you come in. Being a filmmaker is my dream, but like all dreams, it all comes down to money. The money that will be raised for this project will go towards the film's budget, paying the cast and crew, clearances to pieces of music, and also the submission costs for various film festivals.
Yes, tell them all about the prizes, Sean.
The variety of rewards will depend on how much you pledge to this project, ranging from a personal email from yours truly, to being credited as a backer in the special thanks section of the film's closing credits, or to even sitting next to me at the premiere. There are so many ways to get involved, and not just financially. If somehow you can't contribute to this financially, then that's okay. Just share this video and Indiegogo link to someone who will. Do what you can. Scoptophobia has been a passion project of mine since 2013 and has been something that I have been pouring a lot of myself into. Through two drafts and a lot of contemplation, I hope that with your love and support, that this film can finally get off the ground. Thank you.